One of the big topics being discussed in Vue 3 is around TypeScript. However, for those of us who haven't jumped on the TypeScript train yet, there's understandably a lot of hesitancy when it comes to adding TypeScript to our codebase. In this lesson, I'll be addressing some of these concerns in order to provide another perspective to help evaluate whether or not TypeScript and Vue is a good combination for your project or not. Let's get started. Let's take a minute to level set as far as what TypeScript is. Here on the official TypeScript website, we can see that they define TypeScript as an open source language which builds on JavaScript, one of the world's most used tools, by adding static type definitions. Some of you might be looking at this definition and thinking, static type definitions. Well, if you haven't worked with static types before, let's take a look at a normal JavaScript variable called mystery box. JavaScript, by default, is what is typically called a dynamically typed language, which means that the variables can be assigned any type of value. That means our mystery box label could contain a string, number, boolean, array, object, or something else entirely. While there are a lot of benefits to this, one of the downsides is that it can be difficult to predict how something should or should not behave. So, in the event we had a variable called myAge, we know, as the author of this code, that it should be a number. However, in the event that someone else had to implement a function called increaseAge, without any other tooling, the only way for them to check whether or not myAge is the correct data type is to add a conditional statement to address whether or not myAge is the correct type of number. This is where static types can have a lot of value. With that said, what is the cost of using TypeScript? Like any dependency you add to your codebase, the biggest cost is typically the learning curve and effort required for new developers to become productive with the new tool. As more and more developers come into the world of programming with JavaScript as their first language, this means that with TypeScript, there are a lot of new paradigms and things to learn, which can be very expensive to teams with tight deadlines. And let's be honest, using TypeScript in a codebase seems like it is a little more than just simply adding a library to handle a specific function of the application. After all, when we hear most people talk about TypeScript, their entire application is often written in it, and it's probably hard to imagine spending time rewriting your codebase when most of us don't even have the time to factor the technical debt that already exists. And of course, even when people have added TypeScript to their codebases, that doesn't suddenly mean that their code is bug-free and perfect. After all, like with any tool or technique, they all have their compromises and trade-offs that often require experience and lessons learned to fine-tune so that it fits the team properly. Having heard all this, of course, the real question here is it worth it? The first concern that many often have with TypeScript is that it feels different and strange. However, for those of us who have used Vue for a little bit, the truth is that chances are very high that you've been working with static types this entire time. Don't believe me? Let's dive into a component. Here, we have the proverbial button component, which receives two different props, the color to set the background color of the button, as well as the text, as far as what's displayed inside of the text. While many of us started defining props in this array syntax, as we see here, most of us eventually converted to using the object syntax to better define our props. As we can see here, the color is a type string with default blue, and the text prop is a type string and is required. And for those of us who knew about custom validators, we often went one step further to add custom validators to ensure that the component received the correct data. In the case of the color, we wanted to ensure that it was only passed either red, green, or blue, and that checks to ensure that the prop receives the correct data. After looking over this new and improved version of props on our button component, what you might have realized by now is what we've actually done is assign a static type to our props. In other words, whether you realize it or not, you've been leveraging static types this entire time. Of course, now that we've demystified the use of static types, the real question here that still remains is TypeScript worth it? And while TypeScript has a lot of benefits when it comes to features like type checking, at the end of the day, we have to remember that all tools and libraries have some sort of trade-off and compromise. As a result, Whenever I'm thinking about adding a new tool to the code base, I want to make sure that it solves a specific problem that we're actually having rather than trying to optimize in advance. In my opinion, when a team has little to no experience with TypeScript, the value that TypeScript can bring to a code base ultimately boils down to one factor, scalability. And scalability can be broken down into roughly two categories. One, how large your code base is, and two, how many contributors your code base has. When we look at Angular, which is a highly opinionated framework that was designed primarily with enterprise companies in mind, their decision to make TypeScript mandatory is something worth considering. As a code base grows in size, this often means that there are greater complexity as far as moving pieces that ultimately make the application work. Because of this, TypeScript's ability to provide data structures that the team can rely on can be critical to their productivity. As a result, this is why we see a lot of companies investing in TypeScript for their code bases, because it also provides that additional layer of documentation that might otherwise be lost if the original author of the code leaves and unfortunately happen to forget to comment their code. On the other hand, there are those who are probably thinking, well, my application is small, so how would TypeScript benefit me? For people in this scenario, TypeScript is particularly beneficial typically if your application has a large number of contributors. The most common scenario for this is those who maintain open source projects. After all, since people can be contributing to an open source project at basically any given time, this means that the ability to provide structure and consistency to contributors is critical. After all, in addition to ensuring that the code base works as expected, it also has the added benefit of reducing the amount of time that maintainers have to spend answering questions or resolving PRs that might otherwise have been solved if static types have been properly defined inside of the code base. So what about TypeScript support in Vue? One of the biggest hurdles that people often encountered when using TypeScript in Vue 2 was that while it was technically possible, there was a rather high cost of entry and some things didn't work as well as some people might have liked. For example, being able to detect types across your Vuex stores wasn't exactly easy, and people often had to make compromises when it came to this. When hearing this, it's no surprise that many chose to avoid adding TypeScript to their Vue 2 projects. For those who don't know though, Vue 3 has been rewritten entirely in TypeScript, which means that developers can expect much better TypeScript support going forward. So whether it's developer tooling such as Vitter or libraries such as Router or Vuex, using TypeScript will become a lot easier. And as a result, the cost of entry is now lower than ever before. This brings us to my next point, which is that TypeScript can be added incrementally. A misconception that many often have is that using TypeScript is all or nothing. After all, if you're going to use TypeScript, shouldn't your entire application be rewritten in it? The reality is that this couldn't be further from the truth. So rather than feel pressured to rewrite your entire app in TypeScript, I recommend choosing a specific feature where you will enhance it with TypeScript to see whether it's worth it for your team or not. And if you and your team are seeing the benefits of TypeScript, then keep on refactoring and adding it until one day, you might just realize that your entire app is now in TypeScript. Let's review. In this lesson, we've talked about what TypeScript is and how it relates to the JavaScript that we're used to writing. We've also talked about some of the pros and cons when it comes to using TypeScript and why it might or might not be good for your project. And finally, we also covered how TypeScript support is in the Vue ecosystem, especially with Vue 3 being released. At the end of the day, the important thing to remember here is that TypeScript might not be a good fit for your project or your team. And if that's the case, that's perfectly fine. However, if it feels like TypeScript might have some value in your current or future project, then be sure to stick around as we go into the fundamentals of using TypeScript with Vue 3. See you in the next lesson.